Good morning, beautiful. What are you doing out here so early? It's nice out here today. By the gazebo to think about things. Have you seen it yet? Ah, it's no wonder someone like him was drawn to it. He seems sentimental, no? Anyway, this is the part where you deflect because we're talking about Archer. Right, of course. Like what? That's your big interesting question? No one wants to get married here. The inn is quaint, but that's about it. Craig would be happy to know that. You know how he was. Did you know that the gazebo was already on the property when we purchased the inn? Precisely. Would you like me to fry us up some eggs this morning? When you're done, let me know. We can discuss today's agenda. Thank you. Ah, the woman of the hour. There she is. We were just talking about the tree lighting ceremony. I'm going to be giving you the night off for it. Archer says he's going too, so I'll just close the inn and we'll all go together. Well, if Mr. Lane doesn't mind.
As long as you show me the best spot to see it all go down.
That's Riversong's best-kept secret, but I can oblige for you two. Oh, trust me, the front is not all it's cut out to be. You have to deal with Riversong's snooty council.
I want to be a part of the crowd for once, so steering clear of the front is probably best.
Okay, good. Now that we've got that all sorted out, get to work, Lilah. Mr. Lane, enjoy your stay.
Yes, Lilah? No one wants to be alone, Lilah, especially not during this time of year. I am very thankful that Anjali invited me. I think it'll be fun. Is it good then? Do you not want me to come along? What can I say? You guys are growing on me. I did, but don't press your luck. I'm going to deny it every single time. Thank you, Lilah. I'll see you around. Gonna head out and sightsee some more.
Is everything okay? Oh, you look terrible. Riverson's cold air finally got to you, huh? Go lay down. You're not fine. Look at you. You've got a cold. You're burning up. You need to rest. If you rest now, you might feel good enough to go tonight. I can attend to his needs today. That's not a problem. Your health comes first. He'll understand that. Don't say but. You're going to rest, and that's final. Want soup? Okay, just call me if you need anything. Some soup, cold medicine, some company, anything. Rest up, sweetheart, and we'll try our best to get you there. I see you're awake. How are you feeling? Better? Worse? Oh, you need to warm up. It's a bit chilly in here. Yep, but Archer doesn't need a lot of maintenance, so I decided to come check on you and make some of my famous chicken noodle soup and ginger tea. I know you hate tea. Stop it. Let this warm you up, and then you can take some medicine. Archer should be back by then. Oh, when he heard you were sick, he volunteered to go and pick up some medicine for you. I was surprised too. He's taken quite the liking to you, huh? Mm-hmm. Whatever you say. Make sure you thank him. Yes, of course, sweetie. Drink up. You're back.
Yeah, I, didn't know which one to get, so I just kind of bought all the cold medicine. Oh, and there's some tea bags, a blanket, and orange juice. I thought you would be sleeping. If you're sick, then there's a high chance that I'll get sick because you're working with me, and there's only like three of us here. So I'm saving humanity. You're welcome. Stop smiling at me like that.
I appreciate it as well. You are our guest. We're supposed to be caring for you.
You and Lilah have done more than you realize for me, so a little shopping doesn't bother me at all.
Don't even worry your little head about it. We can watch it on television together. I'll still tell Archer my secret spot for the best viewing.
If you guys are staying, I'm staying too. Things aren't as fun when you're alone. Maybe I can crash on the couch and watch it on television with you guys?
Oh, I don't mind. Please don't feel as if you need to do anything. The tree lighting really is a fantastic experience up close.
Lilah said something to me the other day about Christmas magic. Yeah, I don't know if it exists, but I doubt a sparkling tree is gonna show me that. The movies always say it's family and friends and giving. I know that you're excited to go see the tree. I'm not going to rub that in your face by having a good time without you. So if you'll have me, I'll be more than happy to spend more time with you ladies.
If you're trying to say that you enjoy our company, we accept the compliment.
No, it doesn't bother me. But hey, let me get dinner tonight. We can have some hot chocolate and maybe some of Lady Lacey's famous chocolate cake.
That would be very nice. Thank you. That was very nice of Archer. You two are very much alike. I can't believe that you don't see it yet. You're both full of pride. It was very hard for Archer to admit that he was concerned about your well-being. Just like it's hard for you to admit that you're starting to get attached to him. Embrace it. Some of the best things in life happen when you share moments with other people. For so long, it was just you and your mom. Don't you think that it's a good thing for you to be branching out and letting other people in? Not necessarily. I thought about the same thing when I found out that Craig was gone. I said goodbye to my mom, to my dad, to my siblings. So saying goodbye to the one person who was a constant in my life was the hardest thing I've ever had to endure. I thought for sure that I would never ever let anyone else in again, not even friends, because I never wanted to feel that low again. I isolated myself in the mountains, but people wouldn't stop trying to get me to let them in. Finally, I just had to let my resolve go. And it was the best thing I've ever done. Because no matter how small the amount of time spent with me, each and every person I've met has impacted me in some way. So even if he says goodbye, you can look back on this and be grateful for what he helped you to realize. No, you tell me. You worry too much about things. Everything happens for a reason. Even the bad things in our life make us stronger. You can't dwell on things that you don't even know are going to happen or not. Yes, of course. I'll get some work done so that we're not swamped this weekend. Feel better, sweetie. Morning, sleepyhead.
You're gonna miss the tree lighting. How are you feeling?
You have perfect timing, Lilah. It's just about to start.
Welcome to Riverstone's 96th annual tree lighting ceremony.
You notice things that other people don't. Thinking about how every person in the crowd is feeling, regular people are focused on the tree. Thank you. That was incredible.
Very well put.
It's cliche to say this, but I really do mean it. If more people thought like you, the world would be a better place. And here you are, fighting back on the compliment.
It's called self-sabotage.
Tonight, we will be doing something a little bit differently. In order to honor the holiday spirit of Riverstone, we will be ending the ceremony by singing Silent Night together. Because though it is quiet tonight, great things have come about for our community and for our faith.
Lilah?
Hey, if I said anything in there to make you upset or to second-guess yourself, I'm sorry. I really do think it's amazing the way that you think about people and how you see the world. I wasn't trying to make you feel bad about it. Can I ask why? You don't have to tell me. I'm not asking to exploit you. I'm not asking because I'm being nosy. I'm not asking for any personal gain of my own. I'm asking you because I care. You might not really think that I have a heart, and sometimes I don't think I do either, but for you... Yeah, I mean, I told you what those girls did when we were at the snowman building competition. I've always had to be a little bit careful, but honestly, you've proven to me that there's no reason not to trust you. You don't care about getting anything from me. I'm not. I can't be mad at you for wanting to create art. Everyone takes motivations from everywhere, and then we twist that to fit our expression, but that's not what's bothering you, is it? Why does Silent Night bother you so much? Sorry to hear that. No, but that doesn't mean people can't express their condolences. They're apologizing on behalf of the world for what you have to deal with. It's not something that will heal the wounds that you have, but I'm just offering up my words of support. I don't think that anyone should have to deal with loss, but it's something that makes us human. Music can be a very powerful thing. The way that we interact is unique to ourselves. So a song that meant a lot to him could mean little to you, but that's nothing that you need to feel bad about. I want to tell you that you can't blame yourself for this, but knowing you, you'll fight me on it. You can't change the way a person feels. Did I change the way you felt, or did I mask it? There are things in life that are deeply personal, things that no one really has the power to change. Sometimes things happen. Sometimes life throws a hurdle at you. I'm not articulating myself correctly. I know I don't have to say anything to make you feel better. You're not telling me about your brother's death for my sympathy. But I still want to offer my comfort. I don't want to see you cry. Since I can't find the right words, how's this? Yeah, I don't really care. Not like I have anything to do in the next few days anyway. If you tell anyone about this, I'm gonna deny it. No, stop that frowning. I'm only joking. If I hear you say one more time that I'm some untouchable celebrity, it isn't. It's not true, Lilah. I'm right here talking to you, aren't I? I don't believe that you really believe that. I think you want me to be some untouchable celebrity, the same way that I want you to be an annoying, exploiting fangirl so that I don't have to get too close. Jolly knows best, doesn't she? You're too headstrong. I'm nothing like that. Hey, I'm very accommodating. You're stubborn, loud, aggressive at times. You're still a DeLuca fan. Well, just remember that DeLuca isn't the one who's comforting you right now. When you're ready, there's chocolate cake.